Now, I quite think I understand it. Please may balance me. God, it has been said that look, investigation into the alleged abuse by Ramaphosa at an advanced stage. So in other words, Ramaphosa is being investigated, and every investigation into the abuse of power is at an advanced stage. Now, I'm worried about the coincidence in terms of how things are happening. You know what I'm saying? It just worries me. There's something worries me there, but don't worry. We'll unpack all of that. So there's an article that was written by EIOL, by local. The person who wrote the article is Thabo Makwakwa. Yeah, ne? Makwakwa. Okay, I'll chill it out. The Office of the Public Protector, South Africa, has indicated that the investigation into allegation of abuse of state resources by President Cyril Ramaphosa was at an advanced stage. But unfortunately, they put inverted commas, advanced stage. So right there, for the fact that IOL decided to put inverted commas, you know what they are trying to tell you about that. Do I blame them for putting it in an inverted commas? Definitely no. I don't blame them for that. Definitely I don't. So what I'm going to do, because now we are very much in advanced stage, we will need to dissect each and every single thing that has been said here. So we can understand, because we want to make sure that we bring everything and we glue all these pieces together. But I want to tell you something before we get there. Hey, guys, what you don't know is this thing. Pala Pala, nobody's following Pala Pala. We are being taught about VPS, look, ETA. VPS is much more important than, this is what they said, VPS is much more important than the Palapala one. Hey, this one is less important. Hey, that one is very important. VPS is not a new scandal. Just because they signed a deal with Ramaphosa that they will not vote for his impeachment, thus they can't talk about Palapala. That's what they should have said. We compromised ourselves. We can't talk about Palapala. That's why we are focusing on the VPS, because we can't talk about Palapala based on the contract that we signed. For us to be in a GNU, we're not gonna vote against Ramaphosa. That's why now they want us to focus on anything else except Ramaphosa. So they're very unhappy with what we are reading here now. The fact that other people are saying Palapala, Woza, was also accountless. Funugwazi ukuthi kwenzakalani ePhalaPhala Farm. Oh, now people are, look, this one's the DA. Nkukhunqi lokho inqunya umlomo. Babindwa isidwa. Hey, my dad, atluleni lapha. Bangaze bathi mina ngithe. Yo, siyapi? Sila. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying, will bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Now, Umakwakwa, Thabo Makwakwa said, the probe followed a complaint lodged in October 2022 by Elias Muller requesting the public protector, Koleka Taleka, to investigate Ramaphosa in what he described as a violation or contravening of the constitution, abuse of power, state resources for the benefit of African National Congress, the party Ramaphosa he leads. Okay. Well, Ramaphosa, well, Ramaphosa, Austin, when Senusuma. Hey, I think you're going to pimp. That's a niche bongana. You're going to pimp as pass a miss. Come back at the video. Come back at the video. It is, look, in his complaint, Muller told Kalega that Ramaphosa used the SA Defense Force SANDF helicopter to attend an ANC campaign in Welkom on 8 October 2022. Now, this is what, I quote, "The president failed to conduct himself in a manner that is beyond reproach as required by the constitution of the country." I quote, "The president was attending an ANC Letsema campaign in Welkom Free State province. I believe that the president crossed the line between party and state, and as such, his conduct was irregular." Okay. So, the man continued to Muller said, "The president's irregular conduct is a clear abuse of power, abuse of state resources for party interest, violation or contravening of the state constitution that he took oath to uphold. I believe that the president failed to live up to the standard required for someone occupying his office, which is the highest office in the country," Muller wrote. So, is he lying or not lying? I think the man is telling the truth. That's why I said to you guys, even if you're saying about Malema stole 30 million, Ramaphosa stole 5 million or 2 million, based on the position they occupy, Ramaphosa's sins will still weigh more because he's the president of the country. He must defend the constitution. So if he's found on the wrong side of the constitution, his case must be worse than everyone else. He also asked Kalega to investigate Ramaphosa's handing over of the RDP houses during the Letlhakga campaign in the Northwest Cape, in the Northern Cape, where he arrived at the home of Omar Mata Low in Dankok as part of the campaign activities. He celebrated her 82nd birthday and the official handing over of the new RDP home. Muller said the president was conducting a private ANC activity and not a state business when he handed over the house.
Hi, Melenda.
No niggas are zonke lendaba. Muller wrote and said, "It is irregular and unjustifiable for an RDP house built with taxpayers' money to be used by a political party instead of the government. I believe that the president is abusing his power during his party Letsema campaign, as we saw previously how he used a machine belonging to one Mpumalanga municipality to fix potholes during Letsema campaign," he wrote. The public protector's office said it will release its findings soon. Ah, tell me, do you think the finding will find Ramaphosa wrong? I'm just saying. Do you think Ramaphosa will be found wrong? I doubt. But let's proceed. The PPSA can confirm that it is investigating the matter regarding the alleged handing over of the RDP house during the ANC Letsema campaign. The investigation is at an advanced stage and the PPSA, Public Protector as South Africa, will release its finding in due course. Public Protector as South Africa spokesperson Khulu Password. Not password, God. Please don't mistake that. Not password, though. Right. So that's what they are saying. You want to tell me what you're saying. But it's also said that the dilapidated state of the staff primal mission equipment with more than 85% of platform grounded and the clear evidence that no money to maintain provide essential upgrade and ensure that our pilots and air crew are compliant with the minimum competency level of flying DA member Parliament, Cobos said. You know, talking about Palapala, for instance, Palapala fires everybody that seems to contradict the locals, you know, everybody that is sitting somewhere in power fighting Palapala, that person will get fired. We all know. It has always been the case. That's why Pelambosisi Mkhwebane is not in the office, because she went against Palapala and Palapala was like, you know what? Hey, when I got to Zuba in King, I went, I go. Aye, mama, aye. You know, just like that, mama, I got to Zuba in King. I got to email a layak. Oh, okay. So what? I go, mama, I go. That's Palapala for you. So, judging from the tendencies of Palapala, I don't think this woman will last if she ever goes against Palapala. So, I mean, I think the finding will favor Palapala, or somehow it will be neutral. Because some people are scared. They don't want to lose their jobs. Ramaphosa has defended the ministerial handbook, saying the state was required to ensure that political office barrier, including ministers, deputy ministers, premiers, MEC, were provided with resources and enabling facility to perform their duties effectively. They say the guide to members of the executive provide a framework to manage the extent to which the state provide these tools of trade. The adoption of guide is not done in terms of any legislative provision, but it is the result of a cabinet decision that the tools of the trade need to be defined and regulated, he said, responding to DA leader John Steenhuisen, who had asked what legislative provision he had relied on to allow the existence of the ministerial handbook. I wonder. Okay, let me read this part. This part is very important. Meanwhile, a former National Assembly Speaker Nosifu Mapisan Nagula had a salary docked, and the ANC paid a portion of its share of the cost for the lift she granted them to meet with the ZANU PF Zimbabwe while she was a defense minister. The cost of the trip was 332,000. NC portion was 105,000 rand. That means she paid the balance, right? Ramaphosa called it an error of judgment and decided to dock Mapisa Ngagula's pay. Yay. Hi, then two legs of friction to two thousand villain part of Tonga Mangola Maposa. Upton of village, but on a serious note, now let me ask the ask. It might probably be difficult for others to answer the ask, but somebody have to ask this ask at the end of the day. And that ask is, judging from the behavior of Palapala, do you foresee a situation, circumstances, whatever you want to name it, where the public protector, the current public protector, will get to a point where she rule in favor of Ulamlam? Personally, I don't think so. Like, honestly speaking, not in favor of Ramaphosa. I don't think so. The current public protector is not a problematic protector as far as the current regime is concerned. So if she had changed her behavior, I think it would be now. But I don't think so. I don't think she will do that. Honestly, I don't think so. For me, I'm expecting those in two ways. I'm expecting them to either find Ramaphosa not guilty or to be somehow neutral, so that she can shift that responsibility to another department. just like they've done with the Palapala issue. Like, honestly, they just shifted, they just decided that let's shift the responsibility to a certain department, but not us. So we're not going to be the ones that are finding him guilty. Even though when you look at the things that were said during that time, you could realize that, no, this man ought to have been held accountable. But that's not going to happen. Not Palapala. Held accountable. Never.